say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home.
That was our national anthem performed by the talented Skylar Cole. And with that, we'll be right back in just a moment. Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And we're pleased to have on the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, take it away.
Thanks very much. Well, Commissioner Adam Silver has a history lesson for those who would tell players to shut up and dribble. He says, in 1963, Bill Russell was MVP, won a title, and stood on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial for Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech. There is a through line that exists directly from Russell to our modern players. Kevin?
That's a great story, DA. Thanks. Get ready, folks. These two teams love pushing the ball. Greg, we could see a track meet tonight.
Two of the top fast break teams in the league, Kevin. As far as keys, limiting turnovers is going to be big because they each want to get out and run when they get the chance.
And the starting lineup for the Timberwolves. Out on the perimeter, Edwards and Anderson. Underneath in the post, Towns and Gobert. And it's Russell in at the point. And for the Lakers, the three stars on the floor together. Westbrook at the point, LeBron and Davis at the forward spots. Patrick Beverley out there with Thomas Bryant.
LeBron James just reads the floor so well. If a lane opens, he will exploit it and get to the cup off the drive.
Left side, Edwards, and the foul called on Russell Westbrook. That is his first foul of the game. On defense, the Lakers. Anderson, a screen on Westbrook. Here's Russell, and the slam dunk by Russell.
So a point guard who can flush it with authority. D'Angelo Russell takes advantage.
Here are the Lakers.
And this Lakers squad has a ton of talent, but some guys are well past their prime.
Davis, the pass to Westbrook. About 1 minute into the first quarter. Nice D from Russell. And what do you think, GA, is the next step for this Lakers team?
Coming off a championship not that long ago, young firepower is surely needed. These older guys can't carry a team like they used to.
Down to five on the shot clock.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Davis kicks to Westbrook. Here he goes. He can't hit that time. Nice D from Russell. And it's Russell with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Anderson outside. Pass to Towns. The fadeaway. The shot off that time. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Westbrook passes to LeBron. Westbrook with a screen for LeBron. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Now, guys, this is superior strength by James. Even when the defense roughs him up, he's more than capable of playing through them. It's amazing.
Hard to believe, Greg, last season, LeBron missing the playoffs for just the third time in his career.
And Kevin, it almost felt surreal to not have him in the playoffs. I mean, this guy's been a fixture in the postseason for almost two decades now. Just another bullet on LeBron's incredible resume.
Free throw good, LeBron.
And the assets traded by the Wolves for Rudy Gobert surprised a lot of people. In essence, five first-round picks, three of them unprotected. They better hope this thing works out. A lot riding on it.
Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play. It's going to be Towns shooting. That one on Davis. And Karl Anthony Towns said he believes that he is the greatest big man shooter of all time. What do you think?
Well, Kev, I think a guy by the name of Dirk Nowitzki might have a thing or two to say about it, but I love Karl Anthony Towns' attitude. You have got to believe in your skills if you're going to have the kind of success that Cat has had in this league, and we know he is lethal from deep. But we know this, Karl Anthony Towns was a go-to option from the very first moment he stepped in the lines of an NBA court. The versatility is so difficult to match up against.
Now here's James. He has five. If you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Russell from long range. Rebounded by the Lakers. LeBron outside. Towns against Davis. And Kyle Anderson gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. And here's Westbrook from the arc. That one doesn't drop. The Timberwolves go the other way with it. Edwards kicks to Russell. We're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. Towns a screen on Westbrook. And Towns the bucket on the assist by Russell. Towns has got five.
Don't you love how Towns' hands are always ready to receive the pass? Terrific job on the pick and roll.
Lakers have gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Westbrook passes to Bryant. Outside, Davis. Four on the shot clock. And the rejection by Towns.
Perfect timing on that rejection. Boy, Towns really improving on the defensive end.
And Anderson kicks to Russell. That three off the mark. And it's Davis with the ball for the Los Angeles Lakers. Trailing by two. No one near James as he lets it go. No good on the triple. Minnesota's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. Anderson against LeBron. Russell with it. Towns a screen on Westbrook. Russell, no good. James looking around. To end the cold streak. Another miss by LeBron. The Timberwolves have gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Russell kicks to Edwards. Wow, drew the contact and that three almost went in. So he'll go to the line for 3 free throws. It's his first trip to the line.
How about last season? Made about 79% of his attempts, so those are really quality numbers.
He misses the free throw.
Boy, young talents like Anthony Edwards, so exciting to watch. You know, you've got to adapt to the NBA and continue to grow and reach your potential. But there's this infectious joy and a great smile that he plays with.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Naz Reid, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. McDaniels comes in for Towns. Torian Prince, he's checked in for Kyle Anderson. And it's Noel in for D'Angelo Russell. And he misses all three. The Lakers trail. Davis dishes to Schroeder. Here's the screen. Back to Davis. Over Reed. And that one released in time, but no good. And there's the horn. We've seen some good defense on both sides, and the score is still close. Timberwolves lead by two. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back. And we hope you're enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far in the scoreboard. And guys, what's your take so far in the Timberwolves?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
Well, we know the NBA has worked to get rid of the hard foul doors, and the league has done a great job of doing that. What has contributed, though, to that line of thinking?
Well, I think any play can be reviewed, Kevin, and that's a good thing, because if it's a non-basketball play, then you open yourself up to a flagrant two. The punishment is significant enough to discourage the action. I love the rule changes as it relates to this particular infraction.
And so in the game for the Timberwolves, McDaniels is out there with Taurean Prince. Then there's Reed, and it's Noel in at the one. And he's good on the first of three. Greg, here's a classic NBA question. Who's been the best franchise in league history? The Celtics or the Lakers?
Come on, Kevin. You are putting me on the spot. But I'd go with the Lakers. More superstars over the years. And I think that 2000s run with Kobe and company, that put them ahead in my estimation.
Nails the third.
You want to contest this guy's shot, but you absolutely don't want to send him to the line. He will make you pay.
Pass to Davis. Shoots over Reed. Count that one. And the Timberwolves lead has been cut down to three on the bucket from Davis.
We are talking about a very solid passer at his position. Schroeder identifying an open teammate.
Noel passes to Forbes. Pass to Prince. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
High activity, challenging the heart of the defense. Taurean Prince is not afraid to mix it up.
And Walker's got the ball here for the Lakers. Schroeder outside. Outside for Davis from outside the arc. Oh, good on that one. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Prince, the pass to Noel. Back to Prince. Here's Reed. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway.
Listen, that's a shot he can make, but obviously the defense okay letting him shoot it.
Walker, the pass to Toscano. Outside, Davis. Five on the clock. Davis sets a screen. There's Schroeder. The three-pointer, no good. Minnesota leading by five. The pass to Reed. 2 minutes now played in the second quarter. Pass to Noel. Shoots over Schroeder. Lakers with the rebound. Here's Reeves. No points in the game yet for him. Now Schroeder. Now on the scoring column with that bucket. One for two this game.
Well, Schroeder is 6'1" with a thin frame, but make no mistake, he's got balance and the ability to play through contact.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Now, here's McDaniels. And two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. That one on Davis. And something you always hear about Jaden McDaniels, Doris, is how effortless he makes the game look.
Kev, when I watch this guy play, I feel like he glides through an NBA game. There's a finesse that you don't necessarily see from players his size. He's a handful on the low block. This young man is brimming with potential.
He's off on the first. Both teams will make substitutions. And he sinks the second. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Back to Westbrook. Walker with his screen for Westbrook. And D'Angelo Russell picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Los Angeles making a switch here. Beverly's checked in. And a change for the Timberwolves. Anderson, he's checked in for McDaniel. Russell against Westbrook. The kick out to LeBron. Just 5 on the clock. And the Lakers with another miss. Minnesota leading by 4. And the rejection by James.
An engaged LeBron James on the defensive end is an absolute menace.
Westbrook passes to Bryant. And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play.
You simply must put a body on this guy. You know he's going to try to get to that glass.
And here's Russell. Towns a screen on Westbrook. Here's Russell. Scores for only the second time tonight. Now 2 for 6 from the field.
Well, he's getting better at absorbing contact. Finishes like this prove Russell is a tough, dynamic competitor.
Lakers trail by 4. Right side, Westbrook. Knocked away. It's stolen by Edwards. Russell against Beverly. Edwards passes to Anderson. Gobert trying to get open. His three-pointers off the mark. Los Angeles has gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Pass to Westbrook. Here's LeBron, shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. It goes on Kyle Anderson.
Well, the basketball IQ of LeBron James is off the charts. So adept at finding ways to get to the line.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he can't get the first one. Doris, one thing that stood out about the Timberwolves last season was their fast-paced play.
No doubt, Kevin, and you can trace that directly to the head coaching position in Chris Finch. This is a group that loved to push the basketball up the floor, wanted to catch defenses before they had a chance to dig in the half court. And remember, that is the classic mark of a youthful team, particularly one with the athleticism that Anthony Edwards brings.
Now here's Anderson. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And there's the call on Juan Toscano-Anderson. That is his first foul of the game. And right now, let's watch that terrific swat.
Yeah, quick thinking pays off big. What a block.
So it's the Timberwolves now. 3-point lead. Shot and game clock separated by 5.
Westbrook has the ability to create havoc with his athleticism to challenge shots.
LeBron James on the wing. Jacks up a three. No good on the last second attempt there. And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. Timberwolves ahead, up three. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Carl. Impressive start for you. What's the mentality going into a game like this?
Just being aggressive. Really played well at all the first half myself. All of us are missing a lot of easy bunnies. We're missing layups for us as pros. So second half, if we make those layups, we should be fine.
We'll see if you stick to the script. Thanks very much, man. Back to you.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball. And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. Timberwolves leading by three. The three stars on the floor together. Westbrook at the point, LeBron and Davis at the forward spots. Thomas Bryant is out there with Patrick Beverley. That's the group starting the second half for Darvin Ham. And Los Angeles guys shooting a pretty sorry 29% from the floor here.
And really, whatever your take on Russell Westbrook is now, you can't deny his place in NBA history. Voted as one of the NBA's top 75 players of all time.
Six to shoot. Davis setting the pick for Beverly. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. And it's Russell with the ball. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. It's a three-point game. And now we've got some time to check in from the sidelines. You got for us, D.A.?
Thanks very much. The Lakers are, of course, one of the league's storied franchises. And Magic Johnson was asked recently if they have the best all-time collection of players. He says, it's not even close. Outside of Bill, we have all the dominant closers. Kobe, Jerry, LeBron now, Worthy. Come on now, it's just too many Lakers. Kevin, back to you.
Well, he's got a point, David, and we thank you for your report. Greg, it is impossible to argue against Westbrook belonging to that top 75 players list, isn't it?
It really is, Kevin. I mean, his career numbers and accomplishments speak for themselves. A very unique player, easily one of the best during his prime.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power
and hammering down the two-hand slam. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions right now. They need a basket. Exactly what they want right there. Continue to get good looks.
Here is Russell following the basket by Russell Westbrook. Russell finds Edwards. Towns, a screen on Beverly. Edwards can't hit.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Davis dishes to James. Back to Davis. And he uses the glass on the layup. And now just a one-point Timberwolves lead.
Well, this is why you can run the offense and play LeBron at point guard. If you're open, he will find you.
Passes it to Towns. Back to Russell. Davis against Towns. Over Davis. Towns, no luck.
And the fadeaway was the only option he had on that one. Defender there all over.
And it's Davis missing.
Boy, surprised he missed that. The defense just good enough to prevent that bucket.
Russell kicks to Edwards. Anderson a screen on Beverly. For three, Edwards. He gets hauled in by Los Angeles. Davis has got his fifth rebound in this one.
And last year, Minnesota had a tough end to their season. In their 10th playoff appearance, they made their 9th first-round exit.
Here's Edwards. Russell Westbrook with the rebound. Westbrook's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Outside Bryant, and there's the pass to Davis. And that one goes long. I don't think the Timberwolves, Greg, plan on letting their playoff statistics discourage them at all.
And that's kind of the beauty of this squad. They're out to make new franchise history, not focusing on the past. Just keep evolving as a team.
And the Lakers decide to take their first time out here. A new lineup here for the Timberwolves. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Schroeder kicks to Walker. Pass to Toscano. Davis looking for an opening. 5 to shoot. Davis setting the pick for Schroeder. Can't tie it up as that one misses. Timberwolves leading by 3. Pass to Forbes. Here's Noel. From outside, off the mark. And Walker's got the ball here for Los Angeles. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Schroeder outside. Passes to Davis. Reed with the block. And so it looks like the Lakers will retain possession here. And we got to take a second look to admire that outstanding block.
And this is why coaches stress the importance of defense. Big block there in this close game.
6 on the shot clock. Here's Walker, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up. The Lakers have shot 2 of 3 from the free throw line tonight. And the first one drops. And so Walker nails both of them. 23 seconds left here in the third quarter. Here's Noel, guarded by Walker. Shots good by Noel.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
And that one drops for him.
Instant offense. Dennis Schroeder can fire up his team with that pretty dribble drive.
Here's Noel. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. Timberwolves lead by 1. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. The Lakers trail. So on the floor for Minnesota, 2 big men inside, Towns and Gobert. Out on the perimeter, Edwards and Anderson. And it's Russell in at the one spot. Toscano passes to LeBron. Clock at 6. Over Gobert, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
When you consider how far into his career LeBron is, the fact that he is still a force and that he is as versatile and fearless as he has ever been is nothing short of remarkable, guys.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. Russell Westbrook in for Dennis Schroeder. And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Here is Russell. Anderson up top. Back to Russell. Edwards trying to get open, and Russell gets it to go on the assist by Anderson.
This guy, an effortless scorer. Outside, inside, in between. Dynamic scorer is D'Angelo Russell.
Westbrook wide open. He fires. Drills it from outside. And the Lakers lead by 2.
That's a huge three-pointer. He'd love to become a go-to guy for them here in crunch time.
Yeah, and when he gets going, he adds another dimension to their offense that can make a huge difference when the game's on the line.
And here's Edwards following Russell Westbrook's 3. Shot from 12. Here's Towns, and Towns throws it down.
Exactly what you love to see from Cat, that aggressiveness, that assertiveness on the backboards.
The Lakers shooting has been wayward so far, only 37% from the floor. On the wing, James. The shot from the low post is good. LeBron's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And that was the right call. When you need a basket, go to the guys you trust the most.
Well, you've got to earn trust and equity by making shots. Nice delivery there.
Towns is doubled. And there's the whistle, 3-second violation.
And those are the kinds of mistakes that are magnified when we're talking about a game down the stretch.
Ryan is checked in for Los Angeles. Patrick Beverley comes in for Lonnie Walker. Westbrook surveying the D. He dishes it to James. Back to Westbrook, beyond the arc. Minnesota with the rebound.
That's a look you cannot pass up. It's also one you shouldn't miss.
Cannot believe he missed that one. Ooh, I'm sure he can't either.
Bryant with a screen on Anderson. James finds Bryant. For three, Edwards. And once again off the mark by Minnesota.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on D'Angelo Russell.
We know that Russell Westbrook isn't afraid to mix it up inside. He knows how to get defenders to hit him on these opportunities.
That free throw, no good.
Perhaps the thing I will remember most when Russell Westbrook decides his career is done is how he brought competitive fire and spirit every single night, guys.
Davis has checked in for Toscano Anderson. Good on the second free throw. Timberwolves trail by three. Russell kicks to Gobert. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it.
Anthony Edwards is a load to handle as a defender. This guy's got the frame and the skill to make it very difficult.
And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for the Lakers?
The mid-range game has been there for them all game long. And that old-school approach still getting it done in this one.
You know what else has been important is they've been focused and they have gotten themselves to the line, made their free throws, doing all the little things.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
You get the sense this guy relishes getting to the free throw line in these tough moments. You talk about clutch, this guy is it.
Westbrook passes to Bryant. Back to Davis, just five to shoot. Yes, it's James picking up the assist. James has got three assists in the game. Here is Edwards. 1:52 left in the fourth quarter. Anderson right side. Back to Edwards. Gobert trying to get open, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Being the number one overall pick always comes with expectations to deliver in the clutch. Standing at the free throw line in just such a moment, Mr. Anthony Edwards, what you got?
Shooting two.
It's the first one, and that brings them within two here.
People are holding their breath a little, wondering if Edwards can take care of business here.
And he cannot convert on the second. That misses.
Only down two now, but that miss might come back to haunt you. If they don't get a stop, it's back to a two-possession game.
LeBron up top. Edwards defending. James. That one goes in. LeBron's got the lead up to four now for the Lakers.
Well, should any of us be surprised? If they need a bucket, LeBron says, get me the ball, and delivers once again.
The Timberwolves shooting poorly, just 35% so far. Here's Edwards. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And that narrows the lead down to just three. And Edwards drops him both.
And now down to a one possession game. Those foul shots, huge.
The drive by James. The kick out to Westbrook. The pass to Davis. Let's it go with a three. And James with the basket on the assist by Davis. James has got 9 points here in the second half. 102 left in the game. Gobert with a screen on Beverly. Edwards can't hit.
Simply put, a bad shot, guys. They all know they can get a better look than that.
Here's Davis. Gobert with the block.
Rudy Gobert, a consistent force on the defensive end, does a nice job sending that one back.
For three, Edwards. And James pulls it down.
I'll tell you, this has not been his game, and he's making it worse with shot selection like that.
So they foul intentionally. Gets the first, and that increases their lead to six. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 7-point game.
Well, you want to continue to build the lead. So a very productive trip to the line right there.
And the Timberwolves call time here. They're down by 7. 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
Yeah, they got to get straight to the hoop, then a foul immediately.
30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. No one near Edwards as he lets it fly. Yes! And now they trail by just four.
And he is built to be the man for this team. Edwards answering the bell and executing.
First free throw is good, and that puts them up by five. And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
They got to take the first good shot they can find.
And they've got to be efficient with the clock. Quick score, quick foul.
Out to Russell. Puts up a three. Anthony Davis with the rebound. And that's an intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six. And so he drops them both. It's a seven-point game. Minnesota calls timeout. They're behind by seven. 5 seconds left in the fourth. Guys, your thoughts?
And a little late to implement a plan B. This game is a wrap.
Well, I think he might just want to remind these guys, hey, let's finish the game the right way.
Five seconds left to play in the final quarter. And so the Lakers take the win. It was a fantastic ball game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, I mean, they faced some challenges, but really held firm when they needed to. On both ends, just effective in terms of coming away with this win.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who's standing by with our player of the game. Take it away, David.
Thanks very much. LeBron, when you know AD is behind you, how does that help you defensively?
You can stay home. You can allow him to play one-on-one versus a guard, versus a big, and you can stay home and be able to box out and get rebounds because he's that good.
It's quite a 1-2 punch, man. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now, our New Balance Player of the Game, LeBron James.